Welcome back to 3D Explained, the series that takes you on an exciting journey through the world of 3D printing. I'm Elliot, your host, and in today's episode, we're diving headfirst into the world of FDM 3D printing issues. Get ready to troubleshoot and fix common filament printing problems. Let's start by tackling bed adhesion troubles. Picture this, your prints are warping or suddenly detaching from the bed. It's a common headache for 3D printers. What's causing it, you ask? Well, it often boils down to bed leveling, Z offset, and the cleanliness of your bed surface. Achieving a level bed, fine-tuning the Z offset, and maintaining a pristine print bed can work wonders in resolving these issues. Also, keep in mind that thermal expansion plays a role, especially with materials like ABS, which can contract as it cools. Printing in a closed or heated enclosure and ensuring adequate bed temperature can help prevent warping caused by this contraction. Remember, a solid foundation is key to successful 3D prints. And if all the aforementioned settings didn't work for you, you can always rely on glue and bed adhesion helpers like brims, skirts, and rafts. Oh, stringing, the bane of FDM printing. Those annoying thin threads that appear between objects or during travel moves can wreak havoc on your prints. The culprits here are often moist or humid filament, incorrect retraction settings, or overly slow travel movements. To vanquish stringing, ensure proper filament storage in a clean and dry environment. Tweak retraction settings and optimize travel speeds. A finely tuned printer and dry filament is your best defense against these pesky threads. Now, let's unveil the mystery of ghosting and ringing in your prints. Sometimes, it appears as if your model is caught in time loop. These repeating artifacts along the walls of your prints often result from printing too quickly, loose belts, wobbly eccentric nuts, or an unstable printer base. Bust these ghosts by tightening the belts driving the motion system of your printer and the eccentric nuts found on printers using V-wheels, slowing down your print speed and ensuring a stable printing surface. Your prints will thank you with smoother surfaces. Next up, let's confront the blobs and zits leaving blemishes on your prints. These unsightly imperfections can ruin even the most intricate designs. Blobs and zits often happen at the seam of the layer where it starts and stops. You can mitigate these issues with better retraction settings and slower print speeds. Sometimes, moist filament and over-extrusion can also be blamed for these intruders. Proper filament storage and precise flow settings can help you banish those unwanted guests. Moving on, if we're talking about printing problems, we need to tackle over-extrusion and under-extrusion. Two common challenges that can affect the quality of your 3D prints. Over- and under-extrusion occur when your 3D printer pushes an excessive or insufficient amount of filament through the nozzle, resulting in too much or not enough material being deposited. This can lead to unsightly blobbing, zits, gaps, holes, weak layers, and even nozzle clogs. To address both over- and under-extrusion, adjust your extrusion multiplier in your slicer settings to tweak the amount of filament being extruded. Also, ensure your slicer settings match the actual nozzle diameter of your printer. Make sure your nozzle is clean from any debris and that the extruder's drive gear is well tensioned. Lastly, slowing down your print speed can also help the extruder keep up with the flow of filament. Finally, the dreaded nozzle clogs. There are few things as frustrating as under-extrusion or no extrusion at all, leaving holes in your prints. Low quality or contaminated filament can leave impurities in your hot end, causing clogs. Temperature and retraction settings also play a crucial role, as inadequate parameters can result in filament jamming the nozzle. To combat nozzle clogs, you can try several remedies. Cleaning the nozzle by heating it and carefully removing any debris can often solve the problem. For more severe clogs, try doing a cool pull, and if it doesn't solve the clog, you might have to disassemble or replace the hardened altogether. Also ensure you're using high-quality filament, double-check your temperature settings, and fine-tune your retraction settings to prevent filament from being pulled back too much. And there you have it! We've journeyed through the realm of FDM 3D printing issues, uncovering their causes and presenting solutions to tame these common filament printing problems. And if you want to dive deeper in the world of FDM 3D printing issues, don't hesitate to have a look at our specific guides on 3Dnatives.com. Remember, in the constantly evolving world of 3D printing, every challenge is an opportunity to learn and improve. Stay tuned for more enlightening episodes 3D Explained as we continue to explore the fascinating universe of 3D printing. Until next time, happy printing!